Greetings, my dear students. Welcome to another video in the series of C language. So today we will discuss a very important concept, that is switch case control statements. So let us see how they work and how can we introduce these statements in a C program. So basic structure of the program remains same. Means we start with the first line is hash include stdio.h, then void main, and then whole of the program is written inside the body of main. Now we declare variables which we use during the program. So here in this switch case program, so I'm going to make a menu driven program, which is actually a very important application of switch case. So for that we will have a menu, and from which we can make our choice, and accordingly the task will be done. So let the variables are I, n, num and fact. These are the few variables, and here we print the menu. Now that is printf, let the first statement is one, that give rise to factorial of a number, and second is printf, let me write, I'm just using the keyboard buttons to represent these symbols. Let second is prime, to check number is prime or not, and third option printf, let us have third option is odd even, odd even. So we will check whether the number is odd or even, and fourth option is exit statement. Means exit from the program. So let this be our menu, and let me introduce new line here also, and after that we will have printf, enter your choice, enter your choice. So until now we have just written the basic lines. Until now we have not used any switch or case statement. We'll store that value, scanf, then percent %d in the variable num, that is address of num may be written here. So now we have our choice entered. Now here we write switch statement num. So actually this switch case just work like the electricity board that are installed in our houses, that whatever switch we will press, that task will be performed. Either we press a switch for fan or for a tube light or for a socket, accordingly that application will work. Okay, same case is here, whatever choice we will enter, so that case will be activated. Like here, so accordingly we have case 1. What is in case 1? It's factorial. So in case 1 we will write the logic for factorial. That means, so this will ask for an input whose factorial we want to calculate. So for that we again enter printf enter number in a new line, and let us store that scanf using scanf into variable n that we have already taken, that is address of n. So we have one number. Now we have to write the logic for factorial, and you know, we already have one video on this program. You can check in previous videos. Now same logic we will write here, that is first we initialize fact as 1, okay, then we write loop for here we have I is equal to 1 and I less than equal to n semicolon I plus plus. And what will happen for this loop? Fact will be multiplied by I, and once this loop is over and we have the value of factorial with us, that we will print here, that is factorial of, let me write that number also here, %d. So whose factorial we are going to find? N. And what is the value of factorial? Fact. Okay, so let us have this, whole of this will be printed into a new line, and also we have a few lines after the out, and at last we will have break statement. So once this case is over, we will write break statement. So this is a complete case 1. What is a second option in above Meenu? That is primarity. We will check whether the number is prime or not. So that will be activated for second case. When we enter 2, when our choice is 2, then the program or the code for checking a number is prime or not will be active. So we again enter a number. Let me copy that logic from here and let me paste it here. Same lines. Okay, so this will save our time. And now to check the number is prime or not, how can we check? We just check whether the numbers from 2 to n minus 1 divides n. If we get any divisor, it's composite, otherwise it is prime. So for that we again write a loop for, and here I starts from 2 and I strictly less than n I plus plus. Okay, I hope you can understand what we are doing. Now we have more than one statement inside the loop. So that is if now n modulo division I comparison operator to 0. If any of the I divides n, then that means we have a non-trivial divisor. So the given number is not a prime. So we just print here, printf, that let me have new line here, and %d is not a prime. So what is that? N actually. So n will be printed. So once this is over, and when we have some divisor, there is no need to check other divisors. So we will have break statement here. Which will stop the loop and take us out of this loop too. So once we are out of this loop, then again we will write if statement and comparison with I. If n is equal to I, we will print that we don't have any non-trivial divisor. Okay, so that means number is prime. So let me write new line here, and %d is prime. So what is that value? n. So this will finish this case, and we have break statement. And one more thing that I have added here, that we have more than one statement in if, so those can be written inside curly brackets. So with this, case 2 is over. So let us write case 3. So what is case 3? As per our menu, case 3 is odd even, so which is actually simple. So what we just have to enter the number and check whether it is divisible by 2 or not. So it's very simple. Let me write if n modulo division 2 comparison with 0. You know, if n is divisible by 2, what we print here? Printf, that number is even. Let me write new line, percent d is even. And what is that n value? And in else part, we again write printf. That means if n is not divisible by 2, number is odd. So we write percent d is odd. So we are actually printing value of n as along with this. So this is complete. So we will write break statement here also. Okay, so this is case 3. So now we have reached to case 4. So that is something that is new for us. So we have to exit from the program when we activate 4. So for that, we make use a special function exit. You see, this is a new function for us. When case 4 is activated, we will enter, we will exit from the program. And here, a very important thing that we have to note here, we have to include another header file, that is stdlib.h, standard library header file. So I am again repeating that to make use of exit function, we have to include another header file, otherwise we will have error in our program. So make sure that you are using this library file. So now we have exit, then again break statement, and at last we have default case. So when none of the choice agrees with the given choices, then what will be printed? Then there will be printed wrong choice entered. Wrong choice entered. Let me have some new lines. So this will improve the presentation on screen. So that's it. So this is the whole program. Now let us save this, compile and execute. So as you see on your screen, so the menu is displayed, a factorial, prime, odd, even, exit, or enter your choice. So let us enter choice 1. So we have to enter a number. Let me enter 6. So what should be the output? Factorial of 6. Let us see. And factorial of 6 is 720. Okay, so let me make this odd or even. Okay, so this will improve. Let me save, compile and execute. So as you see, let us enter 2 as our choice. So what we will check now, whether the number is prime or not. Let me enter 59. 59 is prime. Let us compile again. Let us check whether the number is odd or even. So let us enter 52. What should be the number? Even number. to 52 is even. And let us compile again. And what will happen when I enter 4? You see, nothing will happen. We will be out of the program. So it will end because of exit function. And what will happen if I enter a number which is not in our choice? Let me enter 6. So then there will be a display wrong choice entered. Wrong choice entered. So I hope you got an idea how can we write a menu driven program. Now let us make a change that we want ki after one output program will ask us whether you want to continue or stop. Means if we enter yes, then it again enter ask for a choice. So that can be done using a do loop. Let me write do, then braces, and whole of the code is written inside the do loop. And after the closing of switch statement, I have the closing braces and while. So we need to declare a character variable. Let that be char character opt option, and we make use this here. After the closing braces of switch, let me write printf, then we have new line operator. Let me write want to continue, press Y, otherwise N. So, and scanf double quotes percent S for string, and then ampersand OPT, the variable we declared up. Okay, so this will make our program to perform continuously. So this is what I have written here, OPT comparison operator Y. If we enter Y, this will be true. Let me execute. So as you see on your screen, this menu will be displayed, and if I press enter, so it will ask for a number whose factorial we want to calculate. Let I have entered 9 and I got the answer. Factorial of 9 is this. So now next we want to enter, want to continue, press Y, otherwise N. If I enter Y, so it will again ask for a choice from the above menu. Now I entered 3. Now this will again ask for a number which we want to check as odd or even. If I enter 85, answer will be 85 is odd. And now if I press N, program will stop and we will be again on the main screen. So this is the complete program in which we have written switch case statements.